I was actually employee number 5 at eSolar back in 2007, and I joined because I have a passion for renewable energy, and I saw that eSolar was an opportunity to grow along with the growing industry, as opposed to starting in a stodgy industry and working from the bottom up. The company since I joined has grown to 130 people. We've raised $170 million in venture capital, and we built a 5-megawatt power plant from scratch. Well, I think it's a couple of key things. Obviously, from the legislative standpoint, in many countries across the globe, there are renewable energy portfolio standards or mandates. In the United States in particular, just in California, having a 33% renewable energy target means a whole lot of solar and wind and geothermal needs to get built. I think that this is the first time that you have a few events coming together. One, a global concern over the environmental impact of using fossil fuels. Second, a series of governments that have come together, whether within their own countries or between countries, to put in place mandates to build renewable energy. And third, the pricing of renewable energy for the first time in history is dropping dramatically. For solar in particular and eSolar, we're getting to a pricing point where we can be competitive in lots of markets around the world with traditional energy sources. Well, I think it's crucial in both state and federal governments to have one voice that speaks for the industry, especially industries that are still at this point in their growth. The solar industry's come a long way, but if this is going to be globally a force in the energy industry, it's going to have to grow by orders of magnitude, and to be able to have representatives in Washington who are able to speak to all of the right policymakers, make sure that solar's voice is heard is crucial. From a business development perspective, this is the most important meeting of the year for us, Solar Power International. Every year I come here and I'm shocked at the level of people that this meeting is a must attend for them, and that means it's a must attend for us. Well, eSolar has recently we signed a deal with NRG Energy. They bought almost 500 megawatts of power purchase agreements from us. Those are three projects, two in California and one in New Mexico. I think the New Mexico project will probably be the first one to enter construction next year. Additionally, we've signed a 1,000-megawatt licensing deal with the Acme Group in India. They're going to begin construction on their first power plants in India in the early part of 2010. And so I think the next things you'll see out of eSolar are groundbreakings.